Hi everybody, this is Kevin Bailey with DB Services, and today I'm going to show you how to integrate FileMaker with Shopify. Now, there's a lot of reasons why you'd want to integrate FileMaker and Shopify. For instance, if you're keeping track of your inventory, if you want to keep track of orders that are coming or going, if you want to be able to manipulate those orders, you know, cancel them, refund money. Really, Shopify can handle all of that and quite a bit more. And it's all really simple to do with FileMaker. So let's just go ahead and jump on into it, and I'll show you how it works. In our sample file, the first thing you'll see is it'll tell you to create a new private app in your store. So once you've signed up for Shopify, all you need to do is go into your homepage here. Once you're logged in, click on the Apps button, and then down at the bottom it says Manage Private Apps. If you click on that, it'll give you the opportunity to create a new private app. All you need to do here is just fill out the information and then set your access privileges that you want the app to have. Now, I'm going to set it to read-write. I'm not going to be writing any information to FileMaker in this video, or I'm sorry, to Shopify in this video, but I just figure we can check that off. Keep track of this webhook API version here, 2020-01. That's the latest. We'll use that in our FileMaker file as well. Let's go ahead and click save. And once you save that, what it'll do is it'll go ahead and it'll give you your API key and your password. So I'm going to go ahead and enter that in. There's my API key. My password, and then for store name, you'll have that set up already with Shopify. Right up here, you can see that ours is DB Services Store. You'll need to include these hyphens in your store name. We'll be using this in our call. And then, like I said, the API version will just be whatever it told you. The latest version as of right now is 2020-01. And then for this, you can just put in where we are based on UTC time. We're offset by 5 hours. You'll just want to include that because what we're going to be doing in this video will show orders since a given time. So that kind of matters for us. And we'll go ahead and click on this. And now in the file, basically, all we're going to show today is the ability to download new orders. So let's go ahead and create an order in Shopify. If you go in here, you can go to your orders, and then I'm just going to go ahead and create one. We only have one product in our virtual store here. So I'll go ahead and add that one product, FM Quick Start, which can also be found on our website. And then I'm just going to go ahead and mark it as paid. I don't need to pay for it. This would typically happen outside of your system. Customers would come into your website and buy these, but regardless, the orders will all end up in the same spot. So I'm going to go ahead and create this order. And now if we look at my orders, you'll see 105 came in just now, a few minutes ago before recording. I made a one to test. Now let's go back to FileMaker. And basically, when I click this button, it's going to just pull in the information since today at 3 o'clock. You know, right now it's 3:10. So it'll only pull in that one single order. Let's go ahead and click that button. And there you go. It brings in that information, the first name and the last name. That all comes from the customer, like I said, since I made it from internally. It doesn't have my information, but all the other information comes in, and then so much more. In another window, I'm just going to open the order itself, and you can see this is all the information that it is able to pull from that customer. Like I say, it's not got a lot of information about me because this all came through internally, but all of this, and I believe even more information, is pulled in from Shopify with a very simple request. Just to show you, that request can be seen here. All it does is it takes my key, my password, my store name, and the call that it made was this here, orders. And the rest of the Shopify API is really just as simple as that, and I'd like to take a minute just to go and check that out. So If you go into help.shopify.com and check out their reference for their API, you can really see all the stuff that they have to offer. And it's pretty robust through their API, what you can kind of play with and manipulate. What we did was here under orders. If you click orders and just go down to the order itself, it tells you you can create and update a store's orders all from these simple functions. Each of these will tell you what you can do with an order. Again, this is the one that we used. Pretty simple. It just retrieves a list of the orders. But you can retrieve specific orders, cancel an order, create an order, delete an order. There's really a ton that can happen. If we click into our call that we made, it shows you exactly what you need to do to make that call. And again, this is a get call for certain things like updating or creating. You'll need to change your curl to make that post. But for all our purposes right now, this is all we needed was just to make that call. And then down here at the bottom, you can see the response that it gives you. So for our call, just to retrieve all the orders, this is all the information in a giant JSON object that it returns to you. And like I say, it's pretty robust. And they pretty much return almost this much information for every one of their calls. It's kind of astounding how much information they give to you. But the more information they give to you, the more that you can do in FileMaker. Because realistically, if you have all that information, then you can manipulate it to your heart's content. So pretty exciting what they can do. Just a quick look at another one. This one's for specific orders. Same idea, just a ton of information that it sends back to you. So pretty exciting all in all. And then if you if you are interested in other things beyond orders, their API has it all clearly spelled out here on the left-hand side. Products, inventory, events, customers, really just about everything that you'd need to handle can all be handled directly from FileMaker. Be sure to reach out to us if you have any questions, and you can find more information about us in our sample file by clicking the About button right there. Thanks a lot, everybody.